Mid-19th century London. The source of a deadly epidemic in a crowded neighborhood was puzzling city officers. A physician named John Snow started mapping the outbreak with the location of water pumps and cesspools, and a solution was found. The map went on to create history by not only preventing thousands of deaths, but also for showing the role of spatial analysis in shaping public policies for human development. This is precisely what an urban observatory aims to do, mapping data and impacting policies for cities that impact lives, millions of lives. India has 377 million people living in its cities, and this is expected to grow to a whopping 600 million by 2030. Karnataka is one of the most urbanized states in India, with the country's knowledge capital, Bengaluru. The city has been attracting people from different parts of the country and the world. With growth came challenges of quality of life and sustainability. As a response came newer ways of problem solving through data platforms, apps, online grievance redressal, service requests, and so on. The day is not far when many of such different platforms, including social media and citizen interaction platforms, will start talking to each other and make life easier for citizens and city managers. For example, efficient and real-time urban disaster response mechanisms can be put in place. However, as cities are growing, they're grappling with more complex questions that are yet to be answered, such as how to predict spatial pattern of cities, how to plan cities with minimal damage to the regional ecosystem, how to explain and predict migration patterns, how to respond to climate change, and so on. An urban observatory tries to answer such complex questions by connecting multiple large data sets over a geospatial platform. It churns out analysis continuously at different scales. For example, dynamic data from property finder sites and cab aggregator platforms, when mapped with land conversion, building permission, and industrial location databases, can generate very useful geospatial analysis. The output from such analysis can give valuable insights for decision makers and urban researchers to shape future policies. This information, when tracked and compared between cities over a period of time, can give insights for shaping larger urban development policies at regional and state levels. A state-level urban observatory should allow comparison between cities and between sectors across a set of indicators that can help track wicked policy problems. It will work as a living laboratory for cities and urban systems at different levels, with application of big data analysis combined with state-of-art visualization techniques. It allows for generating evidence, propel dialogue between multiple stakeholders, and invoke critical policy response. That is why the concept of an urban observatory goes beyond a command and control center. It is less about automation and more about making sense of data by identifying critical correlations. There remain challenges in building such a platform. We need to crack many bottlenecks by learning from past failures in handling big data, creating the right kind of digital environment, building institutional ownership in a collaborative effort, and choosing priority development indicators. Being a leading science and technology think tank, C-STEP has expertise in both urban planning and designing computational platforms to aid decision making. A number of such platforms have been developed by using the unique capabilities of C-STEP's User Interactive Computer Application Decision Analysis for Research and Planning, or DARPAN. Such multi-screen environment can be effectively used for creating urban observatories. Let us aim to progress towards a new urban agenda with data innovation and create cities that are more sustainable and inclusive.